Welcome to Education Hub. In this video, we are going to talk about pipeline in computer architecture. What do you mean by pipelining? It is a method to realize overlap parallelism in the proposed solution of a problem on a digital computer in an economical way. It allows storing and executing instruction in an orderly process. It is a technique where multiple instructions are overlapped during execution. Pipeline is divided into stages, and these stages are connected with one another to form a pipe-like structures. Instructions enter from one end and exit from another end. To introduce pipelining in a processor, the following steps must be followed. Subdivide the input process into a sequence of subtasks. These subtasks will make stages of pipeline, which are also known as segments. Each stage SI of the pipeline according to the subtask will perform some operation on a distinct set of operands. When stage SI has completed its operations, results are passed to the next stage, that is SI plus 1, for the next operation. The stage SI receives a new set of input from previous stage SI minus 1. In this way, parallelism in a pipeline processor can be achieved, such that m independent operation can be performed simultaneously in m segments. The stages or segments are implemented as pure combinational circuit performing arithmetic or logical operations over the data streams flowing through the pipe. Latches are used to separate the stages, latches such as L1, L2 up to LN. Latches are fast registers to hold intermediate result between the stages. Each stage SI consists of a latch LI and a processing circuit CI. The final output in output register R. The flow of data from one stage to another is controlled by a common clock. Thus, in each clock period, one stage transfers its result to another stage. Pipeline processor can be defined as a processor that consists of a sequence of processing circuit called segment, and a stream of operands, that is data, is passed through the pipeline. In each segment, partial processing of the data stream is performed and the final output is received when the stream has passed through the whole pipeline. Now, the classification of pipeline processor. This type depends on the following factors: level of processing, pipeline configuration, and the type of instruction and data. Now, the classification according to level of processing. According to this, computer operations are classified as instruction pipeline and arithmetic pipeline. Instruction pipeline. We know that an instruction cycle may consist of many operations, like fetch, opcode, decode, and so on. These operations of the instruction execution cycle can be realized through the pipeline concept. Each of these operations form one stage of a pipeline. The overlapping of execution of the operation through the pipeline provide a speed up over the normal execution. Thus, the pipelines used for instruction cycle operation are known as instruction pipeline. Instruction pipeline involves the following steps. These are: fetch the instruction from the main memory, decode the instruction, fetch the operand, and execute the decoded instruction. The four stages of instruction pipeline will work in the overlapped manner. First, the instruction address is fetched from the main memory to the first stage of the pipeline. The first stage fetches the instruction and gives its output to the second stage. While the second stage of the pipeline is decoding the instruction, the first stage gets another input and fetches the next instruction. When the first instruction has been decoded in the second stage, then its output is fed to the third stage. When the third stage is fetching the operand for the first instruction, then the second stage gets the second instruction and the first stage gets input for another instruction and so on. In this way, the pipeline is executing the instruction in an overlapped manner, increasing the throughput and speed of instruction. Overlapped operation in the instruction pipeline can be illustrated through the space-time diagram. First, we show the space-time diagram for non-overlapped execution in a sequential environment and then for the overlapped pipeline environment. This is the space diagram for non-pipeline processor and another one is space diagram for overlapped instruction pipeline processor. It is clear from the two diagrams that in non-overlapped execution, results are achieved only after 4 cycles. 1, 2, 3, 4. Then I2 execute, then decode, then execute the instruction. While in overlapped pipeline execution, after 4 cycles, we are getting output after each cycle. Now come to arithmetic pipeline. The technique of pipelining can be applied to various complex and slow arithmetic operation to speed up the processing time. The pipeline used for arithmetic computation are called arithmetic pipeline. Arithmetic pipelines are constructed for simple fixed point and complex floating point arithmetic operation. For implementing the arithmetic pipeline, we use two types of adder, CPA and CSA. CPA means carry propagation adder and CSA means carry save adder. Fixed arithmetic pipeline. We take the example of multiplication of fixed number. Two fixed point numbers are added by the ALU using add and shift operation. Following stage for pipeline are: the first stage generate the partial product of the number which form the 6 rows of shifted multiplicands. Second stage, 6 number are given to the 2 CSA merging into 4 number. In the third stage, there is a single CSA merging the number into 3 numbers. In the fourth stage, there is a single number merging 3 number into 2 numbers. In the fifth stage, the last 2 numbers are added through a CPA to get the final product. CSA means carry save adder, that it adds 2 numbers such that carries generated are not propagated, rather these are saved in a carry vector. CPA means carry propagation adder, it adds 2 numbers such that carry generated in successive digits are propagated. Floating point arithmetic pipeline. Floating point computation are the best candidates for pipelining. Take the example of addition of 2 floating point number. Following stage are identified for the addition of 2 floating point number. First stage will compare the exponent of the 2 number. Second stage will look for alignment of mantissa. In the third stage, mantissas are added. In the last stage, the result is normalized. Now, classification according to pipeline configuration. It consists of unifunction and multifunction pipeline. When a fixed and dedicated function is performed through a pipeline, it is called unifunction pipeline. When different function at different times are performed through the pipeline, this is known as multifunction pipeline. Now, classification according to type of instruction and data. In this classification, the types are scalar and vector pipeline. Scalar pipelines processes scalar operands of repeated scalar instruction. Vector pipelines, this type of pipeline processes vector instruction over vector operands. Thank you.